I started working in this industry in 99 when I came from Ahmedabad, a small town. And after 10 years of working here in Bollywood, in mainstream commercial Hindi film industry, I've realized that there are lots and lots like me who are still looking for that opportunity, who are still looking for that one turnaround day in their lives when the doors of mainstream commercial filmmaking will open for them. And this is that day. We've come here with Film Goa, which is an initiative to empower everybody who has a filmmaking dream. The hub of filmmaking in India, it all lies between a 10-kilometer stretch from Bandra to Andheri. There are thousands of offices here. Of filmmakers of all kinds, independent filmmakers, producers, corporate houses, studios, musicians, directors, actors, casting people, post-production houses. All of these people in this 10-kilometer stretch are working day and night. They're working very hard to sustain and survive on this industry which is worth a couple of thousand crores. The activity of filmmaking has become so centralized that everything is just happening here in this stretch. And it appears that outside this stretch, there is no future, there is no hope, there is no possibilities for any filmmaker or an aspiring filmmaker to do something. Whenever this kind of a centralized activity happens, there will always be a problem. For every one person that gets his chance or whose day is made, there will be hundreds or thousands others who will be left out with no future, with no possibilities. Normally ये होता है कि आप बॉम्बे के बाहर किसी शहर में होते हैं, छोटे टाउन में होते हैं, and you watch movies and you feel that this was not right, मैं ये इससे बेटर कर सकता था, the end should have been like this, or you know, you have these ideas and when you share it with your friends, some friends will encourage you, some will discourage you. Family 90% of the times will discourage you, most of the family people, because they are worried about you. वो बोलेंगे कि आप डॉक्टर बनो, आप इंजीनियर बनो, आप कुछ अच्छा काम करो, आप क्यों फिल्म मेकर बनना चाहते हो, ये बेकार की लाइन है, इसमें कोई फ्यूचर नहीं है. टू टेल एनीबडी इन इंडिया दैट आई वांट टू डू समथिंग डिफरेंट, आई वांट टू बी अ राइटर, आई वांट टू बी अ फिल्म मेकर, आई वांट टू बी अ ग्रफिटी आर्टिस्ट, आई वांट टू डू टैटूज, एनीथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट, यू आर इमीडिएटली लेबल्ड एज गुड फॉर नथिंग. आफ्टर अ पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू रियलाइज कि ये लोग मुझे कोई समझने वाले नहीं है, तो यू डिसाइड कि मैं अपने बैग्स पैक करूंगा एंड आई विल गो टू बॉम्बे. आपको ये लगता है कि आप जब बॉम्बे में आएंगे तो कम से कम आपके जैसे और फिल्म मेकर्स होंगे या एस्पायरिंग फिल्म मेकर्स होंगे, एटलीस्ट ये लोग समझ पाएंगे कि मेरा पैशन क्या है, मेरा दर्द क्या है, और हम लोग साथ में मिलकर इस इंडस्ट्री में कुछ काम करेंगे. मगर ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता. यहाँ पे आने के बाद उससे ज़्यादा झेलना पड़ता है, बिकॉज हियर यू आर लेबल्ड एज अ स्ट्रगलर, और स्ट्रगलर बॉलीवुड में मेन स्ट्रीम फिल्म मेकिंग में एक गाली के बराबर है. स्ट्रगलर होने का मतलब है आप किसी काम के नहीं हो, नोबडी वॉन्ट्स यू, आप अपने बैग्स पैक करो वापस और घर चले जाओ भैया, आपकी कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. It's a very disillusioning process. Every time it's not possible for somebody to be at the right place at the right time, and they don't get opportunities. And it's a sad thing that they have to pack their bags and go back. There's this really huge community of these aspiring filmmakers who don't have a direction. Why couldn't somebody sitting in Dibrugarh or in Delhi or in a suburb of Pune or Bangalore or anywhere in India, why couldn't somebody who was there be a filmmaker without packing his bags and coming to Bombay and be labeled as filmmaker? It was a radical idea. It was almost an inversion of what the current thought process of filmmaking was. It was as laughable an idea as the idea of sitting away from this stretch and trying to be a filmmaker. It was in March this year, March 2011, that I went to Goa and I started meeting a lot of people in colleges. I started connecting with a lot of youngsters and authorities and everybody alike, and started bouncing ideas, started throwing ideas that what can be done. After a lot of interactions with students, with authorities, with college people, academicians, artists, sculptors, painters, photographers, a buzz kind of started in Goa about Film Goa, about this activity that I wanted to do. A workshop where anybody from India could come, especially if you're in Goa, could come very easily and learn filmmaking in bits and spurts and go experiment, make your own films and come back. And like that, over a period of 6 months, over a period of 5 modules, you could become a filmmaker and start an industry that was self-sustained wherever you are from. That was the basic germ of Film Goa. is probably for the first time in the world there's an opportunity. We are trying to empower you. We are trying to give you the necessary skills, the necessary knowledge, the know-how and the means so that you can be a filmmaker wherever you are. आपके अंदर अगर वो जज्बा है, if you are talented, if you are hardworking, and if you have the passion and if you have good ideas, you will succeed wherever you are. It doesn't matter. It doesn't need. You don't need to be in Bombay. You can be anywhere. You can still be a filmmaker. So this is what sets Film Goa apart from all the other such courses or filmmaking courses. In Film Goa, the whole principle is that living and learning cannot be separated. So the whole idea is, you come to the workshop, you do one module, for 5 weeks you're free. You go back wherever you've come from and you go back and you make your films, you do your assignments. After 5 weeks, 6 weeks, you come back for the second module, learn a little bit more, go back, do those experiments, what exercises have been taught to you, apply them and again make another film, another short film, another something, and you again come back. Then the third module, then the fourth module, you keep on doing this till you have understood in detail each aspect of filmmaking, from the pre-shooting to the shooting to post and various aspects which are connected to filmmaking, like funding and resourcing and how to make a film possible when you have nothing or absolutely next to nothing. That is what Film Goa wishes to do. It comes from a philosophy of mine, which is any community needs 4 E's to sustain and survive and to thrive well and to do well. These 4 E's are energy, education, employment and entertainment. Goa has a lot of energy in terms of resources. It has sun, it has ocean, it has minerals. It's one of the richest states if you consider per capita income. Education in Goa, for the film related things, there are mass media schools, one or two, but there's no actual film school to teach filmmaking. And employment is a big problem in Goa in terms of film industry. Because every year in Goa, some 20 movies are shot. But what are Goans doing in those movies? My friend Deepak says that they are all ABCD in filmmaking in Goa. They are all either aya, butler, cook or driver. Basically they work as junior artists, they work as hands. They are not really employed in any technical capacity in any film. So we need to take care of this, the education part of it, we need to take care of the, automatically the employment part of it will get solved. And of course entertainment, Goa is huge on entertainment, it thrives on entertainment. It is a community which can do very well if there is a sustained growth in the filmmaking fraternity there. I don't believe that infrastructure makes an industry. I think an industry is made by people. Every industry needs its own skill set of people to work in. Like Chennai, for example, they have from a spot boy to a light boy to a cinematic, like they have so many technical people who do great work over there. They have their own superstars. There is an Amitabh Bachchan here, there's a Shah Rukh Khan here, but there is Rajnikant who might be even bigger. So the idea is to have your own people, your own industry. Industry is an industry with people. Industry is never an industry with infrastructure. You might spend thousands of crores in trying to develop a piece of land, but without people, it's not going to work. My vision of Film Goa is exactly to provide for that. It's a long-term vision. We will do this workshop this year. If it is good, if it is successful, we'll do it another year. We'll keep doing it till the time there are enough people everywhere who can make an industry. Each person is an industry in himself or herself. When I came to Bombay in 99, there was two big challenges for any filmmaker who was not in Bombay. There was one big challenge, which was we did not have the necessary skills, we did not have the necessary equipment, we did not have the infrastructure, we did not have the resources. Number two, the big problem was of distribution. To find these two things, everybody was coming to Bombay and trying to find work here. This was back in 99. What happened is in 2002, there was a mobile phone company which came up with mobile phones which could record video. And bam, everybody became a filmmaker because you can shoot a video. If you're shooting a friend's birthday, if you're shooting a party, if you're shooting your family having dinner together, you are a filmmaker, you're already shooting something, right? But still, you did not have the worldwide distribution. And then in 2005, YouTube was launched. And you had worldwide distribution right inside your house. After 2005, the social media came up as a mushroom cloud, and now we have one good thing happens somewhere, or one interesting thing, maybe not good also, but it gets tweeted all over, it gets posted on walls everywhere, and the whole world knows about it. There's no voice which can be kept quiet now. If it is an interesting voice, it will be heard. If it is an interesting thought, it will be shared across the world. This workshop is basically to enable you, to empower you, to create something that will be interesting and engaging to a wider audience, to a very, very wide audience. That is the idea behind the workshop, and that is the necessary skills and the know-how that we are planning to generate and share with everybody. How to create content that is relatable by a huge mass, how to make it more sellable, how to make it more palatable to a wider audience. Because, my friend, if people are going to see it, they won't pay for it. Somebody is going to pay for it if there are enough number of people to see it. So then, films as a mass media, films as a resource that can be used for various purposes. I'm not talking about hardcore mainstream Bollywood movies. There are training videos, there are corporate videos, there are commercials. There's so many things. There's a huge demand and market for content that can be consumed by masses. And it is only going to grow. It's only going to increase. This market is only going to increase. How you can be a part of it, and how you can benefit from it, how you can profit from it, how you can make it probably a full-time job, if not, then at least a passion, at least something that you say which can be heard by as many people as possible. Isn't that a better idea than just your friends and family thinking that you are good? How about the whole world saying, oh, you created something fantastic? This is the idea behind Film Goa. We are realizing as we are going forward in this 21st century, we are realizing that we are more and more community-based species. Human beings are more social. We are now more social than we ever were. And Film Goa is a small effort towards bringing this whole world together. One film, one short film, one little video at a time. I was not very sure of what kind of replies we are going to get, but I was shocked. Within 6 hours of the first interaction, emails started pouring in. And what they wrote was sometimes moving, sometimes shocking, sometimes funny. Every email was genuine. There was a feeling, there was a passion that they wanted to be here. And I was shocked by some of them. Like one girl, she wrote that she gets second rank in her class, but her parents think that she's useless. She said that, I want to become a filmmaker, I want to prove my parents wrong, I want to tell them that I'm good at something. There's another email which came from an actor. He's already acted in 2 movies, and he said that, I want to learn how the other departments in filmmaking work. So I really need to learn that. There was another email from a bright boy. He said that I believe films as a mass media is a very, very strong medium. If pen is mightier than sword, then camera is nuclear. Yes, there is talent. There is talent hidden in the nooks and corners of India, or probably all over the world. There is talent everywhere. There is hard work, there is passion everywhere. It is our duty as filmmakers, it's our duty as an industry to go, to reach out to the talent and find them and bring them and make them a part of this mainstream. So, if you want to be a filmmaker, if you want to be a part of this workshop, send us an email on filmgoa@gmail.com, filmgoa@gmail.com, with these 5 details, your name, your date of birth, your contact address details, your educational pursuit, academic qualification if any, and fifth and the most important thing, answer to this question, why you want to be a part of this industry, why you want to be a filmmaker. Just send us an email, and very soon you will hear it back from us, and we'll tell you how to take it forward and how you can be a part of this community, even if you are not a participant, if you are not one of the chosen ones, because there's only limited seats in the workshop. Even if not that, you can still be a part of Film Goa, because Film Goa is a community. It's a community of like-minded people, filmmaking aspirants. You can join us on Facebook, you can like us, you can follow us on Twitter. We have very interesting tweets and updates coming up every day. And together we hope to create something that will connect with a lot of people.